It's Friday night, we finally made it. It's 80 degrees outside. It is Friday the 31st of March 2017. This is Guadalajara in the state of Jalisco in Mexico. I am Jake and this is Vino Mexico. You have found your way back once again, I hope. Thank you very much for all your subscriptions. Thank you very much for checking out all the videos. Don't forget to check out all the rest of the range, all the great wines we have. By now, you know why we're here. We are here to bring you all of the great wines from all over this great land of Mexico. From the Baja California to Coahuila, Zacatecas, down to Puebla and all over this place. As you know by now, we have an excellent range of wines just waiting for you to try them and to enjoy them. You know why? Because we believe that each bottle of wine has its own story to tell. A story of the place, the people, the land, the air, the sky, the energies, the passion that goes into making these great wines. Because we also believe that wine is about those moments created between people. It's about when you open it and the things that happen while you're drinking it and after you're drinking it. So when you think about Mexico and the people here who are warm, hospitable, pleasant, friendly, blue skies, I mean, this place is just tropical. Doesn't that mean then that Mexican wine is the perfect wine to be shared amongst people? So that is why we're here. So what do? Every single week, by now you know, we get a bottle, we open it up, we try it as consumers, because that is what we are. I am not a sommelier. I am not a wine expert. I am a consumer of wine. I know what wine I like. I know what wine I don't like. I like wine to be fruity. I like it to be tasty. I like it to surprise me. I like it to take me and show me something. So that is what we're looking for, and that's what we're finding here in the Mexican wines. So, what are we doing tonight? We're going to get straight into it because today is a special day and we have a special wine. Today, as a sideline, would have been the 73rd birthday of my father who died 5 years ago. So, in commemoration of that, and strangely enough, my own blood group, and I am informed is the blood group of the family who produced this wine, the second in the series of the wines from the Solar Fortun winery in the Baja California in Ensenada, in the Valle de Guadalupe, I present to you the O Positivo. It says 2014 here. However, we have a 2015 wine, which we are told is the best vintage that's ever come out of this particular wine. This wine, we are told, is the best seller from the Solar Fortun range. It is a very expressive wine. It is a very strong wine. It is a wine that literally has the heart and the passion and the blood type of the family that created it. We are talking from the founder of the Solar Fortun winery, Dr. Jose Alberto Lopez, and the enologist, the winemaker up there in Solar Fortun now is Santiago Lopez. Heart and soul in a bottle. That's what we're all about. So, double special tonight. Come on over here. Bring yourself in. Stick your head in the side. Just go, hi.
Hi. Hi, everybody.
This is my brother-in-law, Victor. He lives south of Mexico City. Somebody has to. And we didn't know he was going here tonight, but he is here tonight. So, it's my dad's birthday. We're all O positive blood type, including the Lopez's. Same as the wine. He's in a surprise visit, so wine is about sharing. So we're going to share the wine. It's Friday night. It's time to get the weekend started. Sorry, that's the sharp end. It's time to get the weekend started. Okay, so as always, we're going to be taking a quick look. This is a Cabernet Sauvignon and Shiraz. So we're going to be taking a look in the book, the Wine Folly book by Madeleine Pouquet. Check her out, www.winefolly.com. Excellent information for beginners and people who just want to learn about wine. It's all in here. Okay, so as we know, from the Casa Madero wines that we had the other week, and also from the Adobe Guadalupe wines, this is, again, the two. It's the Cabernet Sauvignon and the Shiraz. So we're talking, it may perhaps a Rhone Valley style of wine, perhaps even a Burgundy style, who knows, with the warmer climate that you have up there in the Valle de Guadalupe. As we know, it's dry, it's hot, they don't get a lot of rain, but there's lots and lots of sunshine. So with the Cabernet Sauvignon, we're talking fruit, we're talking a full-bodied wine with lots of red fruits leading into the black currants and the black fruits with a lot of wood flavors all the way through. I'm expecting this to be very, very blackberry again. With the Shiraz, again, a good presentation of wood, but this time with more herbal aspects to it. So maybe we're going to get some flowers, some sort of spices, some sort of herb notes in there. A little bit more on the minerality. Again, as I said, with the wines from the Baja California, the minerality tends to lean towards a salinity. The wines in Solar Fortun, that they are working with different systems and different processes, means that these wines are presenting a more of an umami flavor, which is along the lines of, say, soy sauce or Chinese food, the sort of indescribable sort of flavor that you just cannot describe. It's a real thing, honestly, trust, Google it, it's good. So again, we're talking more black fruit. So this is gonna be a nice balance between the black, between the fruit with some herbal spices, some wood notes in there. It's Friday, we've just gotta get straight into this. I'm gonna take a look and see what we can see. 2015, released in about 3 weeks' time, I am informed. O Positivo, Solar Fortun, Valle de Guadalupe, in the Baja California, Cabernet Sauvignon, Shiraz. Another little interesting piece of information while I am just extracting this is that one of only seven Mexican wines, that is on the wine menu of the Thomas Keller restaurant called the French Laundry, which is in Napa in California, and is a 3-star Michelin restaurant. So, you know, if these guys think they can charge top dollar for these wines, you know they're good. So here we go, into the cork. By now, you all know that you do not go down to the last spiral because you risk poking out the bottom. And nobody likes that. Comes out with these. Okay, so as you can see, we know we're gonna check the cork just to make sure that everything has been coming along. This is only a 2-year-old wine. This thing has spent about 8 months in the barrel. So it's been extracting nicely. So it's still very fresh. It's still very, very young. This is a perfect cork. Yeah, there's nothing. So the cork goes in with Speedy. Ba-ding. Okay. We have the wine glasses. We have the wine. The $2 corkscrew has been used. It's Friday. Let's go. Okay, Victor, so if you want to grab, bring yourself in, grab a glass of that, stick your nose in it, have a smell, see what you think.
It smells very good. I want to drink it now.
I know it's Friday, we all want to drink it, man. Just, you got to go through the process though, you know? Okay, the initial smell I get is it's very, very soft. I'm also almost thinking sort of, it hits me like a cotton ball in the face. It's not immediately aggressive. The smell is not hard, it's not abrasive, it's not acidic. But it's tangy and there is sort of light fruitiness and floweriness. It's... Do you get like... Not really roses, but sort of a floral... Well, I get flowers anyways. And I've just been smelling roses all day. Okay, it sounds good. It's time to go in.
You should try to smell some tens of flowers.
Ah,
oh, papa.
That is good. Okay, that
nice.
Is. Yeah, the first, it's acidic here. It's activating the side muscles of my mouth. The initial flavors that I'm getting out of this is sort of a dry herbal that's mixed in, my mouth's watering, mixed in with, it's not blackberry jam, I'm sorry Madeline, your book, it's warm climate, Shiraz, yeah I know. What was it, blackberries, no. Blackberries, zarzamoras, I don't think so. It's more plummy, but it tastes like red apple. Yeah, I'm thinking there's more like red apples in there. Okay, second. I finally got it. Okay. Dark chocolate. Dark chocolate, yes. Dark chocolate mixed with the fruit. So I'm thinking, there's no real hint of cherry in there, but I'm thinking sort of blackcurrant with the hint of the dark chocolates in there with spices and sort of like fresh green herbs sort of being sort of thrown on the top of it. And yeah, there is that something interesting there, and I don't really know what it is. I mean, it's good, very, very good. There's no hint of overly oakiness in there. Maybe a little hint of vanilla, but I mean that just adds to the chocolatey sort of flavour to it. And yeah, I mean it's good. It is good. It's in terms of it's not overpowering. It's not highly alcoholic, but the tannins are there. I can feel them on the back of my lips, on the teeth. And yeah, it's definitely a very good session wine. It's a session wine that you can sit down with somebody, which is what we're all about.
Yeah, I really like.
He's been driving for 9 hours, you know. So you can get it in there, you can drink it with a friend, and yeah, it's it's going to take you through the night. It's I wouldn't call it a heavy body wine or a full body wine. It's, to me, it's more of a medium. It's not light, but it's got punch. It's a medium to full bodied wine, but it's got a bite and it's got a certain something. There's something in there that's indescribable, and perhaps it is, you know, the passion and the love that we talk about that quite literally is the blood of the family. It's very good. Okay, before we do the double glug challenge, I want to do this because this is going to be very, very interesting. Yo, calm down, man. We're going to do this. Okay, this is an experiment. We may keep this in the video. You know, who knows? In this, we have Chateau Margaux 2012. Supposedly the very best that Bordeaux has to offer in here. And what I want to do is I want to line up the best of the French against this to see what, not which one is better or which one is worse, but to see what the differences are and to finally prove, not perhaps to myself, but to demonstrate to everybody else that the Mexican wines, to be quite honest, are more than capable of hitting above their current weight. And to be honest, really challenging the top spot of some of the finest wines in the world. So here we go. This is the Solar Fortun Chateau Margaux Challenge. Side by side. Okay, so first of all, go for this one. This is the Chateau Margaux. I mean, to me, the Chateau Margaux is certainly more complex, a little bit more bitter. There are more sort of spices and sort of a clove notes in there, a little bit more woody and a little bit more of dry. There's less fruit in there, and
it's different, but
it's different. Good. It's still good. It is still, you know, it's Chateau Margaux. It has its reputation. So we go back to the Fortun.
It's more stronger, no?
It is a different flavour.
It is
a very, very different flavour. But it's interesting to see them, the two, side by side.
Maybe we should drink one day one and the other day the next.
Yeah. I mean, the two, this one, the Chateau Margaux, is more, I would say, minerally. This one is certainly more fruity. Is there much to tell between the two of them? I mean, you know, apart from price, where you're talking, this one is 10 times the price of this one. But in terms from a consumer point of view, which is what we are at the end of the day, we want to be happy with what we're drinking, you're going to get the same amount of pleasure out of all of these things. Unless, you know, you're deriving something different out of this, you're going to get just as much pleasure out of this, if not more, because it's got something. It's that something. Watch out for that something. It's going to get you. Especially if you drink two bottles of it. Okay, so having done that, we are now going to go for the Friday night double glug challenge. It's been a hard week. It's been a long one. It's been an unusual one. So you know when you come home at the end of the week, you just want to get into it. And you're going to have to get your face onto the camera so we can see how you react. The trick is you just take it and you take two big boom, boom, like that.
Okay.
And then you just see how your body reacts. So, cheers.
Cheers.
Yeah, it's just a wine that puts a smile on your face. It's a good one. It's not sharp. It's not overly acidic. It's not overly tannic. It's got a thing. It attacks you at the side of your muscles here. yeah, you can quite happily sit down and take this wine and just take it all through the night. You can go through the range of the Fortunes, or you can just stick with the Cabernet Sauvignon Chiron Blend, and you'll be perfectly happy. And at the end of the night, you're going to go to sleep, and you know, because it's not too tannic, it's not too heavy, you're not really going to get any bad effects in the morning, which is definitely what Friday night should be about, because it's just a slow lead-in to the weekend, and, you know, everyone needs to be fresh and bright on a Saturday morning. Okay, so this was the Solar Fortun 2015, really very, very good. It's in conclusion, it has something, but I honestly don't know what it is, but I understand why 3-star Michelin restaurants have this on their menu. It has a thing. It has the fruitiness, the freshness, the vibrancy. It has the passion. It reminds me of the film by Sarah Michelle Gellar, where she's a chef and she's cooking with love. That's what it's a bottle of love. Okay, so this is Vino Mexico. That has been the O Positivo. I want to thank everybody who has joined us for the past couple of weeks. For the people who have stuck with us, you are awesome. For the people who have subscribed, you're even more awesome. So for those who haven't, take a look down here. It's just like down here somewhere. Click that red button, click subscribe, click like, keep following, send this out to everybody in the world, and most of all, comment. Tell us what you think. Tell us if you agree, tell us if you disagree, tell us what you want to see. If you want to see anything else, let us know about it. If you want us to review your wines, send me a message and let us know and we can make this happen. So above all, thanks very much for being here. Have a great Friday night, have a great weekend. I hope you enjoy your wines wherever you are. Look after yourselves, look after each other, and remember, there is always some more Vino Mexico.
See you later, guys.
Salud.